Will you please? He commanded us to be strong and of good courage. Because the weak, the fearful cannot do the work of the kingdom. You gotta be strong. You gotta believe. If there's any fear, give it to the Lord. Fearless. With courage. To do the things that God wants you to do. But from the times of John the Baptist till now, the kingdom of heaven has been suffering violent assaults. And the violent have been seizing it by force. That was taken from the New Testament Women's Bible. See that the kingdom of God suffered violence in the thing, in the way that the forces of evil come against the church, the Christians, and those that are not strong fall and are taken captives by the enemy, but those that are strong seize it by force. They take the kingdom of darkness. I always give something of reflection and meditation on our studies. Reflection and meditation, this is something to apply to our lives now. A, God has an assignment for your life, and don't you forget, God has something for you. Maybe you don't know the fullness of it, but you be faithful in what little you have. You understand, God will give you more. God will move into higher dimensions. There's more. You shall receive power when the Holy Spirit has come upon you, and you shall be my witnesses. We all start by being witnesses, sharing with others freely. We have received freely, we give. You shall be my witness in Pico Rivera, in California, in all the states, and to all the world. We're going to begin by being faithful in Jerusalem, and Samaria, and to the ends of the earth, fulfilling his ministry. B, remember God's spiritual preparation to do his will. Like Joshua, that was spiritually prepared, and when the time came, he was spiritually prepared. Just like Joshua, who understood the importance of his task. Seek him with prayer. I'm so blessed to see the men that are coming, men and women that are coming together here on Monday night to pray. Prayer is the key for revival. Prayer is the key for revival. Thank God for the revival that is going, taking place in our church. But I don't want it to be temporary. I want it to be to continue the prayer. Then you will call upon me and go and pray to me, and I will listen to you. And you will seek me and find me when you search for me with all your heart. See, overcome your spiritual enemies. We all have spiritual enemies, and as you do the work of the ministry, you will have enemies that are going to come against you. But here I'm going to take you again to Joshua. And I keep in the same teaching. How Joshua understood the spiritual dimension. Only do not rebel against God, against the Lord, nor fear the people of the land. For they are our bread. because their spiritual dimension was not the way it should be. But notice that inside, they judged by him. He said, don't be afraid. Their protection has departed from them. In whatever they trusted, is gone. And I want to interpret it this way. That those nations were a people that worship the occult, demons, vampires. These people worship all these kinds of things. And for the other rest of the people, they were afraid. But Joshua saw in the spirit. He saw in the spirit. Oh man, I'm getting here to chills. He saw as they approached his pagan people. Jehovah, the armies of Jehovah, the chariots of fire from God, were entering, and the demons of the people took up. Joshua saw in the spirit, in whatever they trusted, whatever spirit their worship, Babalu, their God. Their protection has left. And when the strong man is in a house and takes a house, all his spoils are good. Okay, going to the gospel. But when a stronger man comes, he runs. The 70 returned and said, Jesus, even the demons were subject to us in your name. We went to these homes and there were people possessed, and when we came with the gospel, boom, the demons disappeared. Right? One time Lily and I were invited to go to a house because this lady was having a lot of problems in the night. Demons were hanging on the walls. And when Lily and I entered the place, they left. It was cleansed. Because we have the Spirit of God.